I'm gonna show you how to find new niche ideas. And this is going to be more of like a freestyle video because when I recorded this, I did not do any type of research. I just kind of just freestyled and just show you the concept and the idea and how I think when it comes to researching and finding different ideas to help me create like a t-shirt design or just a design for a product. Keep in mind, making sure that you're double checking trademarks and copyrights. Don't go off and copy everything that I share in this video, because that's not the goal behind this video. The goal is to help you, give you inspiration, and to show you how to do research.
All right, so I recorded this one, and it was a good amount of content over here in this video, and I had to go back, and now I'm re-recording it because I accidentally hit the microphone and it unplugged for some reason. I don't know what the heck. I'm not sure if any of you guys ever create content, you record, then you realize that when you go to edit the content, there's no audio because the microphone wasn't plugged in correctly. It happens every once in a while. So I'm inside of a merch informer over here. I'm going over here to product research. I'm going over here to one of my favorite things to look at every time I open this tool is movers and shakers, because you never know what you're going to find and you always find something new, which is really, really cool. Mind Your Business, Boulder, Colorado. Now this is cool because it's something like this. You'll see like a lot of gift shops. If you go to a gift shop, like a local gift shop, you'll see designs that are just for, you know, the city and state. So for example, Boulder, California, Boulder, Colorado, or like, you know, and there's another one, like, let's say for example, like San Diego, California, or Las Vegas, Nevada, or New York. There's so many different ideas when it comes to this, and understanding like what people want to buy. You know, these people want to wear these type of t-shirts when they go to vacation, you know, to that certain area. And one cool thing too that we're looking at is, I like this because it's showing us a sales rank over here on the back end. But if you're new to this, this is basically when you see something like this, that means it's selling on Amazon.com. And if it drops down again, if it just goes, so it's made a sell because it's tracking the record. And then if it drops down, that means it's made a sell. Then it goes up and it means it made another sell. So that means we're looking at this because Amazon shares this data with us, and we leverage it to understand that there is a demand in this niche for us to make sales, right? Which is really, really powerful for us, especially if we're doing research and we're trying to find a top selling niche where we can know we can create a design in and it can make sales for us. Can't hear you. I'm gaming. Let's go down a bit more, bro. Did you even show your work? Top research design vault, 240 plus niches. Now I just updated this. So now I was doing research every month. Now it's weekly. So you get new ideas every week. And now the next thing on my list is to increase that. But obviously I want to find low competition niches with a demand. And that is the goal. Now it can be a struggle with certain evergreen niches. And I understand that. I've been doing this for a while, right? I've been doing this for about 8 years, print on demand. And when it comes to that, one of the things that I like to do is when I like to find niches with the demand, I like to focus on like current events or special events happening. So for example, like Halloween's coming up, that's going to be a big one. What else is coming up? Thanksgiving, Christmas, it's all that stuff is coming up upon us for Q4. And that's some of the stuff that I'm going to be including pretty soon as far as research ideas for Halloween. So the next one I'm going to release is going to have some new Halloween ideas on there. And I think I'm going to rep out probably about, you know, 50 to 100 different ideas for Halloween, but also keep the evergreen niches in there too as well. So I'm just trying to provide more value for you guys, especially if you're getting niche ideas, keywords, and then these low competition niches for you. That's very, very important. This is going to help you make money. And that is the goal with this, is to help you understand how to do research. But not only that, is give you an idea of how I would do research, right? So this is an idea of the spreadsheet that you get every week with all the keywords, the niche, the number of competition, and the link for inspiration. And then these are my personal numbers all time with my Amazon Merch on Demand account. So you can look at this right here for social proof, but the top research design vault, sign up for it. It's only $10 a month. So much value back there, so much different inspiration, different ideas. And that's the goal, to help you make more money with your print on demand business. And it doesn't matter what you're doing. You can be doing Amazon Merch, you can be doing Redbubble, Etsy, Spreadshirt, TeePublic. It doesn't matter where you're selling t-shirts. Back to school, right? Math teacher, funny math teacher. I think this is good because of back to school. I got a black kid. This is an interesting one because I feel like we can leverage AI to create something really cool with this one. I am ready for school, but is it ready for me. This is cool. I like that one. And bro, did you even check your work? I can see something like this doing good. But you know, certain phrases like this, they're just doing good all year round, right? And you can, by looking at the t-shirt, you can tell that there's a demand for this. And this is a cool one too as well. We got a black cat with the sunflower, right? Which is cool. I think AI can create something really cool that would be, you know, compete with this type of design. So now we have this. Let's come over here and we're going to look at this t-shirt. So one cool thing, as it's looking good on some of the darker colored t-shirts, you can see that 4.5 out of 5, 14 ratings. Ooh, 14 ratings. We come down, let's see the all time BSR. Yep, consistent seller. This is what we look for as print on demand sellers. We want to see a consistent seller. And of course, we've done research where we find designs that have a really good BSR where they're just consistently selling every day from the looks of it, right? Same thing with this one. Let's check this one out. All time sales. Yeah, selling in July. You can see it's selling in July. And then does good again, like in the middle of October. And then May, June. Does good, and then not sure what the heck happened right there, but this seems like a decent design. Let's come over here. Bro, did you even show your work? All-time sales. These are designs making sales. Now one thing is, just we want to leverage, like, so two things we're going to be leveraging: Ideogram AI for image generator there in ChatGPT, and we're going to leverage the designs in ChatGPT. Now you can do several different things. There's no one size fits all when it comes to any of this stuff as far as research. You could probably have a different image generator that you personally use. There's nothing wrong with that. And then, you know, maybe even you don't like using ChatGPT, you don't like using Ideogram, you want to use Midjourney. It's up to you. Whatever you wanted to use, I'm just showing you the way, like how I would personally do it. Now, we're coming over here. Let's come over here. Let's check this design out. One cool feature inside of Ideogram I like to use, I'm going to show you right now. As far as like trademark checks and all that stuff, one cool tool that I like to use is TM Hunt. Okay. TM Hunt's a really cool tool. Now, as far as like illustration graphics, you just have to be careful making sure that you're not using any words inside of here. There's really no words in here, but you're just more describing the actual design itself. So it's a little bit easier to go around, you know, like, well, a little bit easier to not get hit with a trademark check or any copyrights, because you're just using more of a general terms. And you look at this, and instead of using like phrases on a t-shirt, this is why some people stay away from, you know, text-based designs, because they don't want to check for trademarks and they don't understand it. Let's do this real fast. So obviously cat, it's a single word. It's this one's as far as, you know, checking for that. You can use TM Hunt. I use the Merchant Farmer trademark check right there. That one that popped up. Let me see if I right here, pop it open. You see that? I just use that. It just highlights the words. You can see when it highlights words, you can just click on it and then it'll tell you some information. Then you can go into the USPTO and check it even more, or even just grab this whole phrase or grab a whole title or how you're going to put your listing. Let's say, for example, you did a listing of cat sunflower, right? And let's do that. And then you put it into TM Hunt. You want split search, because it's going to, let's say if you have like a four or five keywords, it will actually check every single keyword or anything in together. And you're looking for, like, you know, two or more long tail keywords. If it's like three keywords in there, you obviously, most likely if it's live, it's going to be trademark. And you can just want to pay attention to that. So, and you're checking for depending on what product you're uploading to. So it goes into even further. I don't want to turn this into like a trademark video, but you're looking for, if you're uploading to t-shirts only, let's say for t-shirts only, you're looking for 025, and then you're looking for t-shirts. It has to say 025 t-shirts. Okay, or tops t-shirts. And that's what you're looking for. When you click on it, you'll bring it in here. It'll go enough a little further, and you can come in here to goods and service, and it'll tell you some information inside of here. And for example, right here, you're looking for it to say t-shirts. But like I said, like with a keyword phrase like a cat, anything like that, it's very hard to, you know, can't really, Amazon's like trademarking cat. We're talking about the actual animal cat, so you should be safe. Now let's go ahead and take that image. We took it. We're gonna come over here to chat or Ideogram, and we're gonna go ahead and upload that actual design, and then we're gonna go ahead and describe that design. Now the AI is generally called fast. Black cat sitting gracefully positioned, two vibrant sunflowers. The background muted gray. And now you can come in here. Background, you just put muted. It says muted gray. Sometimes you'll see like a t-shirt background. You want to erase that, because the goal is to, obviously we're going to put this design on. You can put it on a t-shirt, right? The goal is to put it on a t-shirt, but we don't want it on a t-shirt mock-up. So muted muted, the background is a muted gray. So we can just leave that because it's not saying t-shirt or anything like that. So what we're going to go ahead and do is go ahead and hit generate, and it's generating for us. Now let's go ahead. And so we're going to go ahead and take the, so now look, for example, look at ready, welcome. I just using the merchant form or trademark check. You can use the TM hunt too, exactly what I did there too. So there's a few ways you can check for trademarks. And then I am ready for school, but is it ready for me? You know, you can even do like a Google search to make sure that it's not in like it's not coming from like a popular TV show or any type of movie or book or anything like that. And we look like we're in pretty much in the clear with this one. So we could take the same image too as well. And we're going to grab that one, which is really cool. Cause look at it. We're literally coming up the way that this process that I'm showing you. It's like, we're never going to run out of ideas. We're going to come up with even more ideas. We know it's selling. We know that it's making sales. And our goal is obviously to make sales too as well. So we're going to do the same thing with the next text-based t-shirt, right? And we'll go ahead and use them in my trademark check. And we look like we're in the clear. Bro, did you go ahead and check that? We look like we are in the clear. And then we'll go ahead and save that image. Now we're going to go ahead and grab one of those t-shirt design images. And we're going to go ahead and type in create 5 different t-shirt sayings like this for me. You see what we did right there? Now, obviously we have to double check for trademarks and all that stuff with this. You can grab this, copy this. A cool thing too, you can come over here into, you know, maybe you want to erase the, and we can do like, I think it's like 10 at a time. And you can do a trademark check by using this tool, split search, right? And then, which is really cool. And we're looking for all live design. And we're looking like we're in the clear. Okay, you see how I'm doing that? I'm just looking for like longer tail key, like summer. No, okay, there we should be in the, we should be fine with that. Go down, we should be in the clear, right? And this is how you would double check for your trademarks. We're looking solid real fast, you know, looking real solid with those, the AI. So now let me go back over here and kind of explain everything. Now it created, basically just, it understood the design, which is crazy, right? So this is very, very powerful. It understood the design and what we wanted. Now it doing that just saved us so much time. Now you can literally just go create, or give me 5 more ideas. Give me 5 more ideas, right? And you can just do 50, 60, 70. And then you just like, give me the best 5 design ideas or sayings that you think are the best, and then go from there. So you're talking, you're giving the AI information, knowledge about, you know, what you're trying to create to give you inspiration to help you, right? Create a design. So you see that, right? And then this is what we're coming up, new school year, same awesome me. These are cool. These are all design ideas. These are all legit right here. And then you can literally, you know, grab the next one. We'll go back over to the Ideo AI right now and grab the next one right here and just do the same thing. And these are all text. This is how you like come up with different text-based sayings, different ideas. And then you just make a list, and you know, one day you just do research and the next day you do the design. So you're not doing everything all at once, or it's up to you how you want to do it. Give me 5 t-shirt designs like this for me. And then I'm going to hit boom, and it's going to go ahead and read that. Now let's come over here back to Ideogram. There we go. Woo! Now look how powerful this is. Now you can also, I have a video that I created too, where you can upscale the image, and then you use any photo editing software or designing editing software to remove the background. Now every, got to keep in mind too, the audience, the marketplace is so big, right? The audience, let's say, for example, the person buying your product, the person buying your design, it's so big. It's not like one size fits all. There's so, people love different designs. Like my top selling designs that I thought were going to be, you know, the ones that are going to be selling the most, sometimes they're not the ones that are selling the most. It's the ones that I don't think they're going to sell the most. So you don't know until you test the actual market itself, because someone may love this design. Someone thinks this design's cute and they want it on a t-shirt. You're not buying the product. The customer is your audience. And obviously, if you know, let's put, you know, a little bit of common sense here. Obviously, if you know your audience and you know who's buying your product, that's what you would do. You would literally, you know that they like this color, or their purple is a cool color right now, or sunflowers, they're going for this. And look at this, they have the little hearts, like little touches like that. People love that type of stuff. So here's the prompt. So we put in a prompt. We had to describe inside of Ideogram AI. It created this prompt for us, and then the magic prompt went ahead and made it even better. So you can see exactly what that is. So you can get an idea. You can go ahead and pause this video and maybe plug in, take the prompt and plug it into your favorite image generator, and maybe you can get some type of inspiration. So that is right there. And this is a really cool, it's a cool design that AI created. Now, Same thing. This one's like, I think this one out of all of them is the more realistic one. It did a really good job. The little hearts too. Pretty cool. This one's really nice. So we look at the magic prompt and get an idea of what, how it created it. And this is what it came up with. It's cool. Look at the little sunflower right there by the feet. This cat is pretty cool. The eyes too. That's my favorite one out of all these four right now, just by looking at it. This one too, I thought was cool. So I like the sunflowers. Look how they look. It just gives it like the touch, right? Seems definitely different from the rest of them, but I like the style that it's going for. The cat looks clean. The shadow, look at this, the detail. Amazing time we live in right now to create something like this within minutes. And here's the magic prompt too as well. Take a look at that. And then the next one, this one's cool. This one's the cat, I want to say, looks a little more happier here. So a little bit of a smile, a little grin on the face of the cat looking up. This one's still pretty good too as well. So, and this is magic prompt. I think they're all pretty legit illustrations or designs in their own way. They're all really good. All right, now let's go back over to, so here are these ones right here. These are the, you know, the four that it created. By the way, this is the four that it created. If you, maybe, what's your best one? Let me know in the comments which of these illustrations is your best one, and why do you think it's going to look better on a t-shirt? So you get the idea of which one of these could be, you know, the one that you think is the best. Because I'm probably missing something, and you see something, you're like, this one's the best one. So this is my favorite one right here. Now we'll come over here. Five saying, so bro, is that your final answer? So now certain things like, dude, did you even read the instructions? Seriously, who needs calculators? Forget the step. This is good stuff, dude. This is really good stuff. And you can literally, like I told you, give me five more ideas. Just getting the idea, the concept, and instead of you coming up with your own ideas, you can leverage ChatGPT and let it do all the, like, the brain power and the working, and you come up with different ideas, and you just create a whole list of different ideas like this. Because, you know, you're probably doing a lot of stuff. As far as the research, that's a ton of work. Then you're doing the research, and then you had to go create the design, and then you got to go grab those keywords and put the keywords into your listing. And remember, it doesn't really matter at the end of the day where you're selling at. We're just leveraging Amazon.com, Merchant Informer, to help us come up with research ideas. And then in return, leveraging AI at our fingertips to help us generate ideas, sales, and, you know, obviously make money. That's the main goal, to make money with these tools that we have access to, right? So just leveraging this stuff and uploading it, so upscaling it. You can upscale the designs, and then you can remove the backgrounds, any of that stuff, as far as anything like I'm showing you here. Upscale the design. You can even upscale it inside of here, inside of Ideogram, and you can upscale it, and then you can download it in the PNG format, and then you can remove the background like in Canva, or you can use Photopea, or you can use Photoshop. You can use any of the design tools you can think of. You can use any of that to help you come up with, to help you remove the backgrounds, not come up, well, help you remove the background. So very, very powerful how I'm showing you all this, looking at different stuff, coming up with different ideas. Merchant Informer is a very powerful tool, and we only got not even to the middle of the page. There's a ton of different stuff right here that, you know, you can use and or get inspiration from and come up with your own ideas. All right, so but one of the most important things is just double checking for trademarks and copyrights. That's part of the game too. Just because I'm sharing this with you and showing you this information doesn't mean to copy the actual design. The goal is to come up with your own idea, create your own design, and obviously create a top selling design in a niche that makes you a lot of money. And my coupon code for the Merchant Informer is going to be down below in the description, 20% off, and you can pretty much cancel before the, you know, your free trial ends.
If you want low competition niche ideas, watch this video right here next. Thank you very much for watching. Peace out.